Greetings, friends of typography. The Latin script is the most widely used alphabetic writing system in the world. It is a bicameral script today, which means every commonly used letter exists in two versions, uppercase and lowercase. But there was one remarkable exception. Over the course of the entire 20th century, one uppercase letter was missing. So how could that happen? Well, let's cue the music and find out. We are used to see and use the Latin script like this, and this style of writing and typesetting is called mixed case, because both alphabets of a bicameral script are used together. But the Latin script wasn't always used like this. In fact, our uppercase and lowercase alphabets represent different points in the history of the Latin script. The uppercase alphabet goes all the way back to ancient Rome. After several hundred years, the typical letter forms had changed to a design with prominent ascenders and descenders. And this style became the foundation of our modern lowercase letters. Time moved on and uppercase letters were more and more mixed in to highlight not just the beginning of chapters or paragraphs like in a medieval manuscript, but also to highlight the start of lines, sentences, or even individual words within a sentence. Eventually, this led to the development of our modern capitalization rules. Today we use mixed case as a default, and this means that almost every letter needs to exist in an uppercase and lowercase version, since almost all letters can appear within a word and at the beginning of capitalized words. There are letters which never appear at the beginning of words, like this Icelandic character, for example. But it still has an uppercase version, because it is needed for uppercase-only typesetting. When a text is only shown in uppercase letter forms, every lowercase letter needs an uppercase representation. What applies to this Icelandic character also applies to the German sharp S character, or SZ as it is called in German today. It can never appear at the beginning of words. But for centuries it didn't have an uppercase version, so why is that? The reason is rather simple. While the lowercase sharp S came into use, a German text was usually typeset using blackletter fonts. And blackletter fonts at that time had rather ornate and decorative uppercase letters, which, unlike Roman uppercase letters, are not suitable for uppercase-only typesetting. So this is why the sharp S character only existed as lowercase letter for such a long time. There was simply no need for an uppercase version. The sharp S couldn't appear at the beginning of words or in uppercase-only typesetting because uppercase-only typesetting was hardly ever used with the German fonts of the time. But this situation changed at the end of the 19th century when more and more German typesetting was done using Roman fonts instead of blackletter fonts. Now a German line of text could potentially be uppercase only and require an uppercase sharp S. This need was immediately recognized and discussed in the magazines of the printing trade, and the articles also discussed design proposals for an uppercase sharp S. After a spelling reform which also led to the unification of the German orthography in 1901, a committee representing type foundries and print shops met in 1903 in the city of Leipzig to define a new standard for the German character set and give instructions for the design of specific characters. As a result of the spelling reform and this committee meeting, the German character set gained new capital umlaut characters, and for the first time, a lowercase Roman sharp S was standardized. And all type foundries were required to add this character to their Roman fonts. Along with the lowercase sharp S, it was also planned to introduce an uppercase sharp S. but unfortunately the committee couldn't immediately agree on a design for this character. So they postponed the standardization and suggested a workaround to printers, which was to use the letters S plus Z instead until a proper capital sharp S design could be agreed upon. Over the course of the 20th century, this practice of using S plus Z slowly shifted to double S. But the workaround of using two uppercase letters for one lowercase letter remained in use for around 100 years. Interestingly, people today often defend this practice as if it is the intrinsically right thing to do, since they don't know it was only introduced as a temporary workaround. Here is a page from the most used German dictionary explaining the situation in the early 20th century. It says, "The use of two letters for one phoneme is just an interim solution that must be stopped as soon as a proper design for the capital sharp S has been found." Some foundries at the time took matters into their own hands and added capital sharp S letters to their fonts, but they weren't widely used. The original plan for an official introduction of a capital sharp S came up several times during the 20th century in the trade magazines, but it didn't yield anything substantial. At the end of the 20th century, yet another spelling reform was passed, and this affected the use of the sharp S character. Now less words use the sharp S, but for the remaining words, the role of the character was actually strengthened. Now the character has an additional phonetic purpose, and this made it even more crucial to have an uppercase version to maintain the phonetic rules in uppercase-only typesetting. And now it should be clear why there is a need for a capital sharp S today. It logically follows from just two points: the sharp S being a full letter of the German alphabet with a distinct function, and the Latin script being a bicameral writing system which allows for both mixed case and uppercase only typesetting. Every letter that can be required for mixed case typesetting must also exist for uppercase only typesetting, or we run into all sorts of problems, like having different spelling rules just depending on the case, not being able to match words or clearly identify proper names, and so on. Representing one character with two other characters can never be a sufficient solution, since as soon as we make that replacement, it becomes unclear whether those two characters stand for themselves or that one original character. So in the 21st century, following the latest spelling reform, the debate started again, and this time it led to the introduction of the capital sharp S. The character was added to the Unicode standard in 2008, which allowed type designers all around the world to add the character to their fonts. And today, tens of thousands of fonts already support the capital sharp S, and so it is safe to use it across almost all electronic devices. And in 2017, the official German orthography was amended to allow the use of the capital sharp S in addition to the established workaround of using double S. So it took more than 100 years to fill that empty slot, and now the sharp S can finally work like any other character of the Latin script. And it is safe to say the new character is catching on. So I leave you with a collection of some real-world uses of the capital sharp S.